Simon & Schuster Audio presents The Science of Spin, How Rotational Forces Affect Everything from Your Body to Jet Engines to the Weather, by Roland Ennos. Read by Matt Godfrey. A PDF of additional materials accompanies this program. To Stephen, Catherine, and Amy, and all of my lovely acquired family. Prologue. Camels in a Spin. On July 24, 1917, Flight Sub-Lieutenant Sidney Emerson Ellis of the 4 Naval Squadron took off on a routine training flight in Britain's newest and most powerful fighter aircraft, the Sopwith Camel. He banked to the right, dived, and inexplicably plunged, spinning into the ground. It was the first of many fatal crashes, as young, inexperienced pilots took their first flights in the plane, a replacement for its predecessors, the Sopwith Pup and Triplane, which were no match for Germany's new Albatross D-3 fighter. With the prospect of losing more pilots and planes through accidents than enemies they could destroy, the authorities plainly had to work out what was going on and seek a remedy. The cause quickly became apparent: the gyroscopic effect of the Camel's 130-horsepower Clerget rotary engine. In these power units, the whole engine, 9 radially arranged cylinders, was attached to the propeller and span around a stationary crankshaft. This apparently bizarre design had several advantages over conventional fixed engines. The cylinders were cooled by the surrounding air as they spun around, so the engine did not need a radiator or heavy water cooling system. And oil injected at the crankshaft automatically flowed outward, so there was no need for an oil pump. Rotary engines therefore produced more power for their weight than conventional piston engines. But there were side effects. Together, the engine and propeller acted as a heavy gyroscope. They resisted being rotated at right angles to their axis, so that when a pilot applied turning forces on his controls, it had unexpected effects. A turn to the left raised the nose of the plane, slowing it down, while a turn to the right forced the nose of the plane down, speeding it up. It was this that caused the uncontrolled descent into a spin that had killed Lieutenant Ellis. As we shall see, this effect was totally predictable from the laws of physics, but until then it had been ignored, as it had not posed a significant problem to aircraft. Earlier planes, even Sopwith's own Pup and Triplane fighters, had also been powered by rotary engines, but these were lighter units that had spun more slowly, and the aircraft themselves had been designed to be inherently stable. Indeed, the Sopwith Pup was described by its pilots as the most perfect aeroplane ever built. But the stability of early aircraft reduced their maneuverability. To obtain better fighting qualities, the Camel had been designed to be more unstable and consequently more maneuverable. The top wing was straight, rather than rising toward the wing tips as was more usual, which would have prevented it righting itself automatically. While 90% of the aircraft's weight was concentrated in the first 7 feet of the fuselage, reducing the torques needed to turn it. The result was a brilliant fighter, but one that could be lethal to inexperienced pilots. By this time, however, there was little the authorities could do to rectify the situation. Pilots were banned from turns to the right at altitudes below 100 feet. And training machines were modified to hold an instructor sitting behind the pilot who could take over the controls if necessary. With these measures in place, accidents were reduced, and the Camel went on to become the most formidable fighter of the war, destroying 1,289 enemy aircraft, and even accounting for the Red Baron, Manfred von Richthofen, himself. The aircraft continued to be a menace to novice pilots, but experienced ones learned to make use of its unusual characteristics, turning to the left in dogfights, for instance, by turning 270 degrees to the right. This historical crisis is just one example that shows how unaware people are about the science of spin. The mathematics governing rotational motion had been known for 150 years when the Camel first flew. Yet even so brilliant an engineer as Herbert Smith, Sopwith's chief designer, had failed to predict how its rotary engine would affect its handling characteristics. And it has largely been fortuitous that gyroscopic effects have rarely posed problems for more recent aircraft. The rotary engine reached the limits of its development in 1918, with Bentley's 150 and 200 horsepower units, after which it was abandoned. After that, propeller-driven aircraft were powered by engines with stationary cylinders, radials, inline, or V, and the gyroscopic forces of the propeller alone have been manageable. Even in jet engines, in which the turbine blades rotate at high speed, the gyroscopic effects are small compared with the aerodynamic forces on the wings, because most of the weight of the engine is concentrated near the center of rotation. But there is no reason to feel complacent. 60 years after the Camel crisis, another affair showed how spin continues to baffle even the greatest minds. As a schoolboy, I was myself present at the 1974 Royal Institution Christmas lectures for young people, given that year by the eminent British engineer Eric Lathwaite, the pioneer of the linear electric motor and high-speed maglev trains. In the fourth lecture, The Jabberwock, Lathwaite demonstrated to a rapt audience some of the seemingly magical properties of gyroscopes, the way they swiveled around their support without any apparent force being applied, and the way they seemed to hold themselves up, defying gravity. Lathwaite even went on to claim that gyroscopes broke the laws of physics. As you might expect, these claims set off a storm of protest from the physics establishment, and prominent scientists were quick to denounce Lathwaite. And confusion about spin continues to reign even to this day. Witness, for example, the recent media storm surrounding the observation by a Russian cosmonaut on the International Space Station, Vladimir Janubekov, that in zero gravity, a spinning wing nut flips its orientation by 180 degrees every few seconds. This observation caused wonder and consternation in equal measure all across the globe. The press pounced on this so-called Janubekov effect, and the physicists who they invited to comment on the phenomenon were unable to explain why it happens. The Russians were even fearful that such an effect could happen to the spinning Earth. If it flipped over in the same way as the wing nut, there would be catastrophic consequences for life on our planet. As we shall see, this is not an isolated occurrence. Many other everyday phenomena, from the behavior of spinning tops to the way children pump playground swings, are subject to abject misinformation on the internet and in physics textbooks alike. This confusion is particularly unfortunate because the science of spin pervades all aspects of the world around us. It helped form the universe, shaped our solar system and galaxy, and controls how they behave today. Spin is responsible for shielding the Earth's atmosphere from harmful rays, so enabling life to survive on our planet. It shapes our climate and weather, from the periodic return of ice ages through the global pattern of trade winds to the local formation of depressions and hurricanes. Consequently, it also shapes the ecology and distribution of life on our planet. Most of the machinery that has underpinned the progress of our civilization exploits spin. From spindles, gears, and flywheels that keep it moving, drills and lathes that shape our artifacts, pumps and mill wheels that raise and extract energy from water, and propellers, turbines, centrifugal pumps, impellers, to electric motors that power the modern world. Most important of all, our bodies are systems of rotating joints and levers that are controlled by our unconscious brain. They produce the complex movements of our bodies that enable us to stand up and move about, brandish tools, throw projectiles, and play a whole host of sports. My aim in this book is to bring clarity to the fascinating subject of spin, so we can see just how it controls the way the world works. Avoiding the mathematics that scientists so often rely on and hide behind, I will provide readers with intuitive physical explanations to explain the mechanics of rotation. Whenever possible, I use explanations from the scientific literature, but these are all too rare. In some cases, I have had to devise my own explanations and arguments. I believe this approach should be helpful even for physicists who have long since mastered the mathematics of spin. It should help them dispel whatever doubts Lathwaite brought up about the laws of physics, banish fears that the Janabekov effect could cause a global catastrophe, and help them communicate better with us mere mortals.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.